In this video, we're going to cover the blocks of some basic components. And so the basic blocks view and how to use the block view. In the blocks view, we have a designer view, blocks view. In the top right, we can select the button to go to the blocks view. And we just have a blank slate right now, but we see that we have several components that may have blocks and several built-in blocks. So to go through the basic built-in blocks really quick, we have control blocks that provide some basic programming. And then we have logical blocks, right? So questions about objects, whether they're true or false, right? So we see in the logic block that we can do equals or not equals to compare two things. In the math blocks, we have the same, but now we're comparing numbers, right? So again, we can see with the dropdown that we could use any of these mathematical logical comparisons. We also have a literal value in the math, so numeric literals, and a bunch of other math blocks that allow us to do math operations. Text, again, we have a literal as the first one. Text is just strings, so we fill in that literal with some sort of string, and then a bunch of blocks that allow us to operate or calculate or figure out things about strings. Lists, groups of things, colors, various colors, or make our own color with red, blue, and green. Numerical values, variables we'll get into later, and procedures we'll also get into later. So those are the built-in blocks. And then we have the any component blocks, which relate to the components we have. We'll deal with those. Those are much more advanced user blocks. For the basic component blocks, we see that they're split into several different colors. Right, just like we saw several different colors when we went through the built-in list, the color scheme is this brownish orange mustard color is an event, right? So everything we want to do with that event, right? So under screen, right, we have events for pressing the back button or the orientation of the screen changed. And then purple is a procedure call, do something, right? Run some procedure, right? And in screen, we only have to hide the keyboard. And then we have a bunch of green, both dark and light shaded green blocks that are for setting, right? Setting is the dark green, or getting a property of a component, right? So we see that at the bottom, we have this title, right? Which was just a word, hello per, or two words, and we could either get it with the light shade or set it to something new with the dark shade. So if we set it to something new, we notice that we have this indent on the side. So we take our literal and stick it on the side, combining the blocks, and change it to something different, right? So right, and now when this is actually run as part of an event, it'll set the title to the value high. Right, so everything is event based. So these first mustard kind of colored ones are the events so that can get triggered. So we have a button, and most common event with a button is tapping it or clicking it. So then we have the button click. So when button one is clicked or tapped, do some amount of operations. So we can say, oh, set screen one's title to high, right? So whenever we click that button, we'll set the screen title to high, and we could do other things like play our sound or pause our sound, several other things, and they just kind of combine in here. So we could say play our sound, and we just stack them together like that. So now when we click our button, the first thing that happens is we set our title to high, and after that is done, it calls sound one play, which plays calls the procedure play to play the sound one file. Okay, any blocks that exist outside of events are just going to be ignored. So these ones up here, they don't actually do anything, and we see that down here in our show warnings, right? So we can show or hide our warnings, and this block should be connected to an event block or a procedure definition, right? So just kind of on its own, it's going to do nothing. So we can either delete it or kind of just leave it there. Most often you want to delete it because you don't want to have clutter all around. So you can either right click and click delete block, or you can drag it down here and delete it in the trash can. If you ever have a group of blocks that you want to save for later, that's what this backpack is for. And so occasionally we set up a bunch of blocks, but we don't really need to use them right now, or maybe we have logic that we built and we think it might be flawed, so we're going to try something else, but we don't want it to delete it and have to recreate all those blocks. We just stick them in the backpack, right? Or if you're trying to debug, we can disable a block. When the block is disabled, that means it's not going to be used, right? Disabled blocks are ignored completely. Okay, so this is the basic layout of the blocks window, right? We can do our media uploads just like in our designer view in case we forgot a media file or something like that. Okay, and then alternatively, if we are in a block that has several, we can delete all the blocks or duplicate all the blocks. Okay, so now we have an error. Okay, if we show the errors, show the warnings, that little thing will come up. Let's scroll down. This is a duplicate event handler, right? So when we click the button, we can't do two things. Right? We can do this event handler or this one, but otherwise it doesn't know what to do, right? If we have multiple things to do when the button clicked, we stack them in here inside our do of our button click, but we don't make another event handler, okay? So this has been the basics of the block view.